Hello, everybody, and welcome to episode 47 of my Waterworld server series. I'm Fixit, and I am here with Howard the Duck with the most awesome armor. Oh, dude, I'm so jealous. I'm so jealous of that armor. Man. All right. So here we're going to work together on a build because it's something that neither of us have ever done. Do you have rocket boots or something on the side of that?
I don't think so.
Ah, there's like red. It looks like a... Does this armor let you fly? Like without an angel ring or anything?
I believe it does.
Oh, that's... I'm so jealous. All right. Anyway, okay. So today's plan is going to be to automate Batania. So I want to do a bunch of stuff with Batania. And I want to make a bunch of different flowers, and I just don't want to hand make all of them. So, Howard, if you want to take this travel anchor and just look the direction I'm looking, and you can port right over to the Batania area here. And I have, fortunately, I have run my refined storage over to this tower. You can do it, right? It's not owner only or anything.
It's not letting me do it, but. I'll find you, though.
I have it public. That's weird. I don't know. I assumed everyone could just use those to zip around my base. I don't know. So, the first thing I want to automate is the petal apothecary. And Direwolf put out a video today that I happened to watch that actually dealt with this. So I'm going to use a few things that I've never done before from his video, which seemed pretty awesome. So I made this reservoir, which comes from, what is this from? Ender.io. And I've built a couple things in this chest. Can you get in? You can probably slip in through my elevator tower. There's like a hole in it.
Yep, I think I'm in. Cool.
Alright. So I put a bunch of stuff that I think I need over here. And one is the fluid tank. Oops. So the first... I didn't really mean to do that. I guess if you shift-click a fluid tank, it works as a bucket, huh? Oh, okay, cool. Alright, so you can set these to be configured to pull water. So there, it's pulling water right out of the reservoir, which is filling up. Awesome. Perfect. Now comes the part that I don't really know what I'm doing. So I made a couple mechanical users. I heard that that is being fixed in the next version, so you can use a mechanical user in someone else's area. Because right now, we're not claiming anything because there has been a bug with Feed the Beast utilities. Now, what do you think? Think that'll work? I probably want to use item on block. Alright, let's give this a shot. Mm-hmm. Let's see. This thing should be set to push and pull buckets. Right? Okay. Oh, you know what? Maybe it's activate block with item. Does that thing have water in it? No, right? Maybe it's not? Have you ever used these before, Howard?
No, I... No.
Mm-hmm.
You put the water in the apothecary?
That... Is there water in the apothecary? And I just can't see it?
Yeah.
Oh.
No, there's water.
Okay. There's a decent chance... Okay, hold on a second. That could be pretty... That's pretty funny. It may have worked so fast that I didn't even notice. Let me grab a empty bucket. Oh. It filled up, didn't it?
Sure did.
And... Sweet. And it has more water. Okay. Awesome. So that's the easy part, right? Hey. There's DNA. I think he's coming on with us, too. Okay, cool. So the next thing is the harder part. I'm going to use probably refined storage. So um, You know what? Can you place the drop? I'm gonna go make another dropper. Can you place the drop? I put all my stuff that for this build, all the stuff I can think of in this chest. Can you place the dropper over top of it, like maybe one block high? And I'm gonna go. I'm gonna go make another dropper for the next part of this. I'll be right back. Craft. I might need two. Actually. Alright. Let's see. So if I use refined storage, you can use any of my refined storage system to get blocks or anything you need, it doesn't matter. So if you request an item from refined storage, it does it it'll do it like in order, right? So, like, say I give it the recipe, like, items, you know, 1, 2, 3, and then 4. 4 being the seeds that will come. Seeds will go last. Does that sound right to your knowledge?
I don't know. With refined storage, I'm not familiar.
Did you ever do AE1?
No, I did not.
Okay. I barely did. We played the Direwolf 1.6 pack. It was like my first big time, like big server. And we did play it. So I wonder if I just hooked up a crafter right to this. Something like, where do I put this? I guess here should be fine.
Will it matter though if seeds are in it first?
I don't know. Maybe.
I don't think so.
You know, I always just threw seeds last, but maybe it doesn't. Well, if it doesn't, that would be easier. So, I guess all I really need is just, like, a cable. I don't need, like... I don't know. Does this have any chance of working, of being, like, the easiest automation ever?
It normally tends to work out that way.
Oh, I find that nothing ever tends to work out whenever I'm doing it, at least not the first try. So other than that just being hideous. Okay, well, let me just go make a pattern. You know what I was just thinking? I'm going to need flowers in my refined storage system.
You have something? So you're hiding stuff down below?
I
was thinking if you used, like, a chest down below and then Ender IO conduit, you could do facade to change the look of the outside if you wanted.
That's true. Maybe the first thing to do, well, let's see if this works first, and then that's true, that's a sure. Really good idea to like make this look a little bit prettier. So I don't know, what's like an easy recipe? I can't think of one single easy recipe flower. What, like a thermal, or what is it? Thermal lily?
Is that day lily? The day lily, is it?
Yeah. Oh, maybe day lily. Yeah. Let me try that. Oh, let me try something I'll use. What's the one that does charcoal? Is that therm?
Endotherm.
Thank you.
Endotherm.
Hey, everyone, say hi to DNA. He's endo. I can't spell endo. Oh yeah. Okay, that's what I want. Okay, yeah, so that's just brown.
Why, if you corrected, it's endoflame.
It's endoflame, I just found it. mystical brown, red, and light gray. Okay, I can probably do that quickly here, and let's see if this works. This is the easy part of the automation. The next part I want to do is the runic altar automation, which I have a couple ideas, but there's going to be some redstone involved, and, well, I think we all know how I do a redstone.
I'd imagine if you put seeds last, that they'd be the last thing that comes through the dropper.
That makes sense, right? Oh, crap. It would have a brown flower. I might be out.
At my base, I do, yes.
Yeah, you don't have to do that. What's that, is it fertilizer?
For fertilizer?
Yeah. Okay, hold on a second. I'm going to have to actually make some red and yellow dye. I'm sure I can get a brown. DNA, you don't have any, do you? By any chance?
Any what?
a brown, just one brown flour, just so I can like test this recipe. No big deal if not.
I probably do. I just got here, so I'll go back.
Oh no, don't worry about it. Hold on. What? I can just I'm doing the wrong thing. I'm standing here doing the wrong thing. What? I can make it with my color thing, whatever it's called. Maybe I can. My atomic reconstructor here. I just need red so I can make some fertilizer. Alright, I'm going to cut and come back whenever I get some red fertilizer. Okay, so I'm making a pattern here for just a simple endoflame. And I'm going to put that in my crafter over my Batania area right here. Now, I should see it from this one, I think. Let's see. Endoflame. Okay, sweet. So I'll put the materials in and seeds. Can I craft one of these? Okay. Anyone have a magnet ring on?
Nope.
Okay. All right. Make sure I don't. Okay, cool. Here we go. Endoflame. The only thing I'll have to do... Why is this... It says it's missing two brown, but that shouldn't be. It has two brown. I may possibly have messed up the pattern. I'll have to go back and check it out. Alright, let's go check this out. Luckily it holds it. Oh, I did. I totally messed it up. Okay, I'll make a new pattern. I don't think that you can erase these refined storage patterns, unfortunately. So I've just been trashing them. If there's a way to erase them, I'm going to feel real dumb because I have trashed a lot of these. Okay, let's try this again. All right, here's the task for the first part of this automation. Nope, that's not what I'm trying to do. Endo flame, here we go. Craft one, go. What is it? Oh, no. Here's the problem. Crap. Okay, so the problem is all of my seeds are set to automatically get redistributed into... this silo. Yeah. So, for now, I'll just grab some and throw them in, but that I'm going to have to come to some sort of long-term solution there, for sure. Okay. Alright. Let's try this again. Throw these seeds in and give it a shot. DNA, what are those wings?
Where'd he go? It's just a glider, isn't it?
So what's going on there? So I have an extra... Seems like I have an extra, Maybe I met... Did I mess up the pattern again? Check this out. Alright, hold on a second. That didn't work at all. Alright, maybe I messed up the pattern. Let me go look again. Shoot. Darn it. What kind of glider is that? Is that... Because we don't have open blocks.
Ender IO.
Oh, I did. I messed up the pattern again. Darn it. I didn't even know Ender IO had a, had a glider. I've never known that. That's pretty cool. Alright. Alright, for the freaking third time. Let's try this again. Endo... Can there's a bunch of seeds. Should have the petals. Can I make it? Go.
There you go.
It didn't go. There's three reds.
Yes, yeah, there are.
The pattern is wrong again, somehow. Yeah, okay, hold on. Now I know that I had it right this time. I checked it. There's no way that this is right. Hold on, I gotta look at this. Somehow this pattern's getting messed up. I have very clearly, I'm sure, two browns, one red, one light gray, and one seed. I'm gonna encode another pattern. Let's check it out. It's like it's messing up here. Two brown, one red, one light gray, and a seed, right? Alright. Let's try it again. I won't have any seeds, though. Shoot, I have to go get seeds.
Yeah, that pattern looks right to me.
Alright, let's give this another shot here. Yes! There it goes. Sweet. Okay, cool. Nice! Awesome. So, easily, I'll be able to set up a, maybe a vacuum chest or something with a whitelist and take care of that. So, that's the first part of the project. That part I didn't think would be hard. Turns out it was a little hard. This part is going to be more complicated. So guys, what I want to do here is I want to automate the runic altar. I have almost no idea how I'm going to do this. So my initial idea was going to be use two precision droppers set up beside each other to drop items down. One will drop all the items for the actual build. And then I believe this thing gives off a redstone signal, I think, whenever it's done. And that will signal, hypothetically, the other dropper to drop living rock, and then use a mechanical user down here. Maybe I'll use like redstone and some sort of repeater delay or something to make the mechanical user click on this. But that's going to be pretty quick, so that the living rock doesn't get picked up. Okay, that's the initial idea. So what could go wrong, right? So I have two droppers. I'm gonna need something to like build with here. Hold on a second. Here, I'll throw these two droppers in the chest. Do you guys want to position those? And the mechanical user can go. Where can that go? Yeah, mechanical user can just go facing the runic altar. Say, let's do it below, actually. So put the mechanical user below it. And then... What are these things? What the heck are these things? What are these things? Oh, are these brown? Oh, yeah, you can bone meal them. What are you, shears or something to get them off?
Yeah, you have to use shears.
Ah, I forgot about that. That's cool. How did you just do that? How did you get that to face that direction?
You look up.
Oh, right. Okay, yeah. Sorry. Yeah, we need to rotate that. That'll be rotate. No, you can do it with a wrench, I think. Which I think I have. Yeah, this needs to be... Oh, maybe you can't. I lied. You can't. I thought you could. So, yeah, these need to be facing, like, each other. You know what I mean? So they'll drop directly down onto, and then, let's see, mechanical user facing up. So then I'm gonna need a crafter. Okay, that's in the chest. Cool. Glad I'm somewhat prepared. I have a bunch of these items set anyway. So. Oh, did I just pick that up? I might have. Nope, I didn't. Alright, then we'll do a crafter. Now, I'm pretty sure these precision droppers will drop directly down, like, if they're in front. So, let's test this out. Yep, right down. No problem like that. I guess I probably didn't need to put a whole stack in. Cool. Alright.
Okay, so that did pick up the log.
It did. Did you put the log in here? Yeah, it didn't pick up the living rock, but maybe it doesn't pick up living rock?
Yeah, living rock has to be the end of the recipe.
So this one over here, without the crafter, is going to be the living rock one.
So it'll be redstone pulse based on the
yes
altar emitting. I think just a conduit. I don't know if we'll need a detector. No, I think it gives off a high when it's done with the recipe, not a pulse.
Yeah, see, that's what I'm thinking. So,
expecting a pulse, or your droppers expecting a pulse.
This one is?
The living rock one.
Yeah.
Is going to expect a pulse. Because if you do anything else, it's just going to keep dropping rock.
All right, whoops. Okay, so what that mean? What does that mean? That means that I need to set up a. We're gonna have to like reverse the redstone signal, right? Like get it to be on. I'm so terrible at redstone. I hate it because I'm terrible at it mostly. What, I'm out of cable? DNA, if your wife ever wants to play on our server, man, she's totally welcome.
She's the one playing in your Britannia field.
Okay. Well, anytime. Anytime. You are welcome to join us. Okay, let me see. All right, that should be set up. So... So this is good, right? So this will just take the recipe for the items that I need. Now the question is going to be how... This will just go automatically. Like, as soon as it gets items, boom, it'll just drop them. Done. Now the only problem is going to be doing multiple items at once. Like, if I wanted to do two runes, right?
Yeah, you won't be able to.
Yeah. I guess I would probably have to... Go ahead.
I was going to say you could use like a vacuum or the hopper hawk and recycle back in anything that doesn't get picked up.
Yeah, but how's that signal going to work? If the runic altar is working, if it's doing a recipe and you drop more items on it, does that interrupt it?
I don't know.
It'll pick them up and confuse the recipe.
It will. Okay. That's not good.
With 82% confidence.
Okay. All right. So, what do you guys think the best way to get a... So, whenever this is working, to my understanding, it puts out one... a redstone of one. And then when it's done, I think it sends a full 15 redstone. So, without making, some sort of hideous, 15-long redstone vanilla build, any ideas on the best way to... I didn't expect that. I thought it would connect. Maybe I should do one. Runic, so we can see it in action.
The first thing that comes to my mind is computer craft, but then we'd be learning open computers before Britannia.
No, I will not do computers ever.
I got sleepy all of a sudden.
All right. Mana powder, mana steel, string, feather, carpet. Okay, I can do that. Hold on one second. I'm going to make one of these and check it out and see. Just check out the redstone.
If you're missing half your nether stars from the refined storage, it wasn't me.
You know, I didn't want to say anything, but I thought I had more nether stars than I currently do.
Oh no, I actually didn't do that. I was just a joke.
I was looking at doing the Wyvern armor today. I was like, man, am I out? I thought I had like four, but I'm sure I'm misremembering. I'm sure that no one would take
it. So it feels like it's doing zero when it has stuff on it.
Okay, but we need to do probably like a real recipe to check out how the redstone works. Okay, let me see. What is that one?
We decided on a test recipe.
I'm looking. I had it, and then of course I can't remember. String, mana powder, mana steel. Okay. Iron and stone. Okay, hold on. I just gotta make some man of steel powder and stuff here.
Super circuit maker comes to mind, but
I don't know anything about that one either. So
it's the basically vanilla redstone, but you've got a tiny screwdriver so that you can make it compact.
Oh, and like one block.
Yeah, it's got some fancy things, but all you need.
That is not getting redstone, definitely. Do you have any more redstone?
Does it need to be up a block?
It's not done yet, though.
I thought that it would...
expecting it to do one while it's building mana, and then 15 when it's ready for the living rock.
There's a decent chance that it has no mana right now, currently.
It does not.
Yeah, I think that there is...
There's a 10. Oh.
Yeah, barely any. Hold on a second. Let me just grab this.
Yes, fix it. Mana's required for Batania.
I see. That should help speed along. Alright, still no redstone, though.
No, but it's only half done.
I thought that it would give out one when it was working.
No.
No, it doesn't. Well, that changes everything. That's not good.
What about raising it up? Use something to detect the runic altar?
You know, I have a scanner, a lot of them, from my failed tree farm experiment.
That was a fun video.
Yeah. Block detector. I don't think. Does that. There's like no options on that scanner, right? That's the only block I can even think of right away that would tell me if it has redstone or not.
Hypnotized automated the runic altar on his.
How'd he do it?
Which playthrough of Infinity Evolved Skyblock. But there's only like 145 episodes to look through.
Ah. All right, well, I'm going to break recording here, and we'll be back when we have a plan. All right,
so works.
We discovered a couple things here, and we discovered that if you use a comparator, it does indeed seem to put out redstone signal whenever this is complete. So I'm just grabbing this same recipe again. I guess I gave it 2 string. I don't know why. And 2 feathers. I completely messed up that recipe. Let's try this. What's on a carpet and string? Okay, 1 ingot, 1 powder, and 1 feather. Good. So that's power of 1. And then when it's finished, it puts up power of 2. I think that's what we discovered, right?
Yep.
Yep.
So we need something to pulse when it gets a power of 2?
This, oops, is that gonna work?
It's 0 before it goes in that conduit.
I know now.
Oh,
right?
Cause it's 1. So when it finishes, it should be 1 going into the conduit. Okay.
Shoot, I can't find my wrench fast enough to make this one. Stupid wrench! I spent today's episode, the one I recorded today, yelling and screaming about how I lost my battery. It was in my pack the whole time. Okay, yeah, so that has a pulse of 1, and that, I think, I mean, it's ugly, but I think that should be working, right? I just need, you guys have a Yetta wrench? I can never find anything ever that I need.
I have a normal wrench.
Thank you.
Thank you. Yep.
There you go. Uh-oh. Oh, no, am I crashing? Oh, okay. There's your wrench back.
Thanks for the Yetta wrench back.
Okay. So this should drop one of these, and it didn't drop it. Ah! Hey, the mechanical user worked. So because I did not click that with it. I used the item just with the button. So with the redstone pulse, I would need this one to go first. So what do I need? Like a repeater with a delay, huh? Repeater. Think one repeater's enough?
Probably.
And then, oh man, look at all these vanilla. Oh, this is breaking my heart, guys. In fact, it's breaking my heart so much that I just can't make myself do it. Let me see here.
Oh, don't look at my original mob farm.
I have someone else's wrench. Whose extra utilities wrench is that?
Is mine.
Is yours here? I'll give it back so I don't lose it. I did lose my Yetta wrench though, so I don't know where it is. This is great. Hey, finding a bunch of crap with a fix, right?
Here, use this one.
I think actually I have enough electrical steel. I'm just gonna make another one because it's really bummed me out that I don't seem to have one. Oh, it's in my A system somehow. All right, cool. So this should work, right? As long as this has a whole. Oh wait, this needs to be on the other redstone mode. It needs to be on redstone pulse. I mean, whether it's solid signal or pulse, it still counts, right? It would still be as like one thing, I think. So let's try another one of these same recipes here. All right, let's see. Does it work? That's the question with this. Man, this would be awesome if it does. I mean, this is amazingly ugly. I'm gonna have to like dress it up more.
It works. It'll surprise me as well.
Yeah, me too. I've never had anything work this quickly. Barely even.
No, I was trying to think. I was trying to think through ideas today of how to get something like this done. Like, for the life of me, couldn't figure it out.
I mean, probably there's about 50 million simpler ways to do it than what I'm thinking than this. But okay, it's done. It didn't do anything. It didn't drop a living rock is probably the problem. Because it's maybe...
The RF Tools timer with a one tick time?
What, so it just runs all the time?
Well, no, to make the pulse. Because doesn't it pause? Well...
Pause on redstone signal. But doesn't have a redstone signal. We need one... that will only be active during getting a signal. How's the hourglass work? How's the Batania hourglass work? It has something to do with redstone, right? Alright, I'm gonna pause. Guys, I can't believe this, but we did it! We did it! After endless tinkering and trying to figure this out, I think this is completely automated now. So, now I don't have a recipe in here yet. I guess I should just make one. What rune am I even making? Rune of Air? Alright, Howard DC'd again. He was the one who figured all of this out. No, just kidding. He DC'd, and we just got lucky after extreme trial and error. All right, so let me think here. So to make a I can't spell anything. Pattern, I don't know. Can I make 64? So to make a one rune of air, it's gonna require me to have way more inventory space than what I have. Get out of here, all this junk. So we messed around so much with like scanners and with different. I mean, we messed around with so much stuff, and it turns out that it's actually pretty simple. The way we're going to do it is just with basically inverting a redstone signal is really going to be the crux of it all. As long as I have string. All right, string, and that equals one rune of air. Holy crap, I'm in the wrong thing. Darn it all. Okay, let's try this again. String, feather, mana steel, mana powder. That equals pattern. All right, let's go give it a shot. So if I put this up here, here is basically, I believe this will do it. I have a bunch of living rock in here. What I'll do is I'll just put an exporter rather, just with a ton of living. So this is just always full of living rock. Under here, I have my wand of the forest that's just always being used. So the second living rock hits, boom, it's done. So let me go request a rune of air and we'll see how it goes. Rune of air, can I craft one? Now, I need to actually put this stuff in here, right? Okay. It needs the materials, it turns out. Rune of air, craft one. Go, get over there. There it goes, it's dropping. Did it drop it all? Is it working? Yeah, it's working.
Yep.
All right, here comes the magic. When this is done, down here, that redstone should turn on. It'll turn off the torch, inverting. And this timer should click. Yes! Done! Hooray! It did drop an extra, it did drop one extra living rock, which is kind of a drag. I think I can probably fix that with, like, I don't know, maybe a hopper hawk, maybe? On, like, a delay? Because you're not going to want a bunch of living rock down there, but I don't think that will mess with the pattern, because living rock will not get inserted as a pattern. Only these materials will, so I don't think that's a big deal. But yeah, guys, we did it. Thank you for the help, and also thank you to DNA's wife for my beautiful flower garden, which in a million years I would not have taken the time to do that, so that's really awesome. So thank you. Thanks, guys. Thanks, Howard.
No problem.
Thanks, DNA, wherever you are, wherever you went.
It was fun. I crashed.
Crashed, yeah. That's how all great episodes
end. No, into the grass over here. I was flying and hit your wall.
All right, guys. Insert your catchphrase here. Do you guys have a catchphrase? Insert your catchphrase here. Bye, everyone. Thanks for watching.
Bye.
Bye.